Good day. Here are the stories for the Manila Times for Saturday, July 24, 2021. The National Capital Region is back in general community quarantine with heightened restrictions as the government stepped up preparations against a new COVID-19 surge generated by the Delta variant. The classification will be in force until the end of July. Palace spokesman Harry Roque Jr. said on Friday, President Rodrigo Duterte approved the recommendation of the Interagency Task Force for the Management of Emerging Infectious Diseases to once again place Metro Manila in GCQ with heightened restrictions on Thursday night, after the Department of Health confirmed the local transmission of the highly contagious Delta variant. The program for President Rodrigo Duterte's final State of the Nation address, or SONA, will be something classy, simple, modest, yet impactful, and will have a Mindanaoan theme. That was how Catherine De Castro, co-chairman of the SONA Working Committee, described the televised production of the event in the Batasang Pabansa Complex in Quezon City on Monday, July 26. Duterte's previous SONA programs were handled by renowned film directors. Internationally acclaimed Brillante Mendoza directed the 2016 production, and the eminent Joyce Bernal took over from 2017 to 2020. This year, Radio Television Malacanang veteran director Danny Abad, who assisted Bernal and Mendoza, will be at the helm. De Castro said the narrative theme of this year's SONA will focus on what can be considered as the Duterte administration's heirloom legacies, but its inspiration in terms of form will be Mindanaoan. President Rodrigo Duterte will be protected by a 360-degree security shield when he delivers his sixth and final State of the Nation address at the Batasan Complex in Quezon City on Monday. Presidential Security Group Chief Jesus Durante on Friday said several security layers will be set up around the president to neutralize any threat. The Philippine campaign in the Tokyo Olympics is off to a bright start. Rower Chris Niavares on Friday finished third in Heat 5 of the men's single sculls to book a quarterfinal slot. Niavares clocked 7 minutes and 22.97 seconds in the 1,500-meter race at the Sea Forest Waterway in Tokyo, Japan. Snacking titan Mondelez International Incorporated, through its local representative, Mondelez Philippines Corporate and Government Affairs Country Manager Joseph Fabul, has expressed its support to the proposal of Business for Sustainable Development Executive Director Bonar Loreto to engage private companies in cleaning up the environment. The company expressed its support to Loreto's proposal during the Manila Times Coffee Break webisode titled Delicious Snacks with Extended Producer's Responsibility, streamed on the Times Facebook page on Friday. The company, behind iconic brands such as Cadbury, Cheese Whiz, Eden Cheese, Oreo, Tang, Tiger, and Toblerone, Mondelez Philippines lives up to its slogan of Snacking Made Right by making Extended Producer's Responsibility, or EPR, part of its process locally. According to Fabul, he said the company name was coined by its employees to mean delicious world. Various energy consumer advocacy groups filed criminal and administrative cases before the Office of the Ombudsman against Energy Secretary Alfonso Cusi, who, according to them, was sleeping on his job. The Power for People Coalition, Sanlakas, and Philippine Movement for Climate Justice on Friday lodged an official complaint against Cusi for alleged violation of Republic Act 3019, or the Anti-Graft and Corrupt Practices Act, grave misconduct and gross neglect of duty, and inefficiency and incompetence in the performance of official duties. The Armed Forces of the Philippines, Philippine National Police, and the Philippine Coast Guard on Friday have signed a tripartite memorandum of agreement aiming to strengthen collaborative maritime security efforts in the West Philippine Sea. Under the agreement signed by AFP Chief of Staff General Cirilito Sobejana, PNP Chief General Guillermo Elezar, and PCG Commandant Admiral George Orsabia Jr., the three agencies were expected to share the Joint Peace and Security Coordinating Center in walks of joint operations, joint intelligence, joint logistics, joint community relations, joint investigation, and joint training and education with its armed units in land, sea, and air assets and personnel nationwide. Topping business, the Banco Central ng Pilipinas said credit standards on loans to businesses are expected to tighten in the third quarter of this year based on its latest survey, with the less positive economic outlook highlighted as one of the reasons cited by respondent banks. According to the results of the Central Bank's second quarter 2021 Senior Bank Loan Officer Survey, the diffusion index approach showed expectations of net tighter standards amid a deterioration of borrowers' profiles and in the profitability of banks' portfolio, less favorable economic outlook, and banks' decreased tolerance for risk. In sports, Malacañang Palace announced that President Rodrigo Duterte has approved an additional 100,000 peso allowance to all 19 Tokyo Olympians and 6 Paralympians as token and to celebrate the achievement of the athletes qualified for the Olympics and Paralympics. Philippine Sports Commission Chairman Butch Ramirez is elated on this development, saying, "Our athletes deserve this additional show of support," adding, "Thank you, President Rodrigo Duterte, for your support to the athletes." The additional support was approved upon the recommendation of Senate Committee on Sports Chairman Senator Bonggo and the PSC. This will be on top of the previously approved $1,000 allowance given by the PSC for each of the 19 Tokyo Olympians. Antonio Contreras and Dien Macabenta are today's columnists on the front page. Contreras talks about the burden of privilege, while Macabenta believes the carbon tax is as good as dead. Today's editorial believes that safety should be a priority for these Olympic Games. Read the full version on the paper's opinion section or listen to the Voice of the Times. For more news and information, get a copy of the Manila Times on print, subscribe to its digital edition, or log on to www.manilatimes.net. Follow us on Twitter, Facebook, or Instagram, and keep up with the Times. On behalf of the Manila Times, this is Eric John Sico reporting. Have a safe weekend ahead.